stop looking at my cards. You're cheating.
Don't be ridiculous. I've been playing bridge for 30 years. I don't need to cheat. Ooh, a jack.
Would you stop that?
It's your turn, Merlene. Merlene, it's your turn.
What? To do what?
I play a card! Get your nose out of that magazine.
It's just this People magazine gets me so angry. I mean, these are not the 25 most intriguing people of 1991.
So, wasn't Taylor over in Little Rock, huh?
Yeah, they went to Barton Coliseum for a rock concert. Hmm.
You're kidding.
No. They've been having a little trouble lately, you know, so Wood thought it might be a good idea if the two of them had a boys' night out. Ooh, Taylor's got a bad case of being 17.
Oh, well, I think it's wonderful that Wood and Taylor can do things together.
Wood was actually more excited than Taylor was.
Come home.
Boy, was that a disaster.
Oh, what's wrong?
We went to a rock concert, we jammed, and we came home.
Yeah, we had to leave early.
How come?
Well, let me make sure that I get all these terms exactly right. We were in the pit. And I wouldn't slam dance. So they chucked me.
Chunked.
What are you talking about?
A bunch of guys picked up Dad, passed him over their heads to the back of the arena.
Oh, that sounds exciting.
Well, really? That sound exciting to you? 10,000 kids pick you up over their head like a beach ball, and they just send you from one end of the Coliseum to the other and saying, pass the geek, pass the geek.
Well, other than that, how'd you like the concert?
Oh, it was great.
It was garbage.
You don't understand anything, Dad.
No. Quantum physics I don't understand. Garbage I understand.
Going to bed.
No, come on back here.
No, honey. Mom, what's the point? I mean, I'm tired of fighting with him. He just doesn't understand good music.
Oh, wait a minute. Now, when I was a kid, we had good music, and if our elders didn't like it, we didn't chuck them. Chunked.
I just want you to know that I understand everything you've said.
Thanks, Merlene. You have no idea how that makes me feel.
You had a phone call. Your new drama teacher, Miss Ryer, called.
Oh, really? What'd she say?
Yeah. Oh, you know, she sounds interesting.
Yeah, well, she's from London. See, she did a little work back in Poland. Disciple of Grotowski's. Theater of Cruelty. Can I go now?
Can I give you the message? She said to tell you that she wanted to know if your play was finished because rehearsals start Monday.
Thanks.
Oh, you wrote a play. That's great.
Yes, I wrote a play. We're doing it at school. It's no big deal. Can I go now?
Good night.
I promise I'm doing the best job I can as a father. I even let him chuck me.
Chunked.
This is a phase he's going through.
Oh, Coach, I wouldn't worry about Taylor if I was you. Just staking out his territory.
You know, bears do that, too. Only they do it by urinating on trees.
What's wrong, Woodrow?
My ears. It was just a concert, I tell you.
Is it a kind of a high-pitched sound?
Yeah.
Buzzing or ringing?
I hear ringing.
Does it sound something like a telephone?
Exactly.
And you better answer it. I love that joke. I don't really get as many chances to use it as you'd think.
Nobody actually saw you go to medical school, did they?
Just relax. You'll be fine in a day or two.
Well, it hurts.
Sorry we're late.
Sorry. Oh, hi, honey. How's your ear?
It's ringing. It's ringing all the time. It hurts, too.
Are you still whining about that ear? Listen, you want to know some serious pain? Try walking around a control-top pantyhose for 12 hours.
Oh, listen, Coach. They showed a clip on TV of that Nirvana concert that you went to. You know something? Those boys were really rocking.
Oh, for heaven's
stop it.
Well, don't get me wrong. I mean, they're not the cow sills by any means.
The music today, they just don't have any great music.
Oh, honey, every generation thinks their music is better.
Well, that's because ours was better.
Yeah. Hey. This is my new drama teacher, Miss Ryer.
Oh.
How do you do? I'm Coach Newton. I teach history and also what we like to call a football team.
Oh, a man of letters, a man of sweat. Nice.
And this is my mom.
Hi, Ava Newton. We talked on the phone. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
This is my Aunt Frida.
How do you do?
Hello.
Assistant Coach Stiles.
My pleasure.
Hello.
And this is Dr. Harlan Eldridge.
Ooh, a man of science, a man of girth. Nice.
Yeah, well, we're here putting up posters for my new play.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, great. Let's see him.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
What's it about?
Oh, it's brilliant. It's Brechtian theater at its best. It's dredging up the very guts of the characters and hurling them in the face of the audience.
Well, that could be messy.
Taylor's play embraces everything I love about the theater. This production will be my very first stepping stone to achieving all my goals. To challenge convention, to hold a mirror up to the vile underbelly of the middle class, and to meet a really cute guy with little or no hairs on his back. Well, nice meeting you.
And I thought Merlin was nuts. You know, I was in a play once. Yeah, in the USO during the war. I played Romeo. What light from yonder window breaks? Colonel Benson played Juliet. I wanted to be Juliet. But what the hell, he was the colonel and he got to play all the great parts. Juliet, Lady Macbeth, Puck.
You'd have been a hell of a Puck.
Yeah, I could have played the hell out of Puck. Fools, these mortals.
Yeah,
we got it, we got it.
Oh, hey, look. Look what Taylor put in the program.
Ooh. This play is dedicated to my family. Oh, that's sweet. Oh, and here's a little poem he wrote. I sit and stare at my cereal bowl and wonder if the earth will swallow me whole.
He's a happy kid.
I want this to be a positive experience for him. It's his first play. I just don't want him to embarrass himself.
Honey, nobody's gonna be embarrassed.
Oh,
oh, okay, everybody, let's all have a good time.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh,
Joe, that looks like your den.
Yeah, it looks exactly like our furniture.
It's evening. A house, a home. Four walls and a roof. A family, four children, seeking out answers to questions unasked. A boy grows to manhood, but there is no one there to harvest the bounty. It's night! A mother. Night mercifully comes to put the day out of its misery.
Hi, honey. You want your binky? Oh, there. That's a mama's girl. Coochie, coochie.
Hello? Oh, yes, counselor. How are you? What? Yeah? Well, I think your client will look just great in the electric chair. I'm just sorry I'm not the one pulling the switch myself.
It's just a play.
And it's very bold.
I was in a play once.
Two children. A boy and a girl.
It's mine. It's mine, little girl.
The fighting is endless. An adolescent, whining, toy-sucking cacophony. Despair surrounds the house like a tattered and torn termite tent. Blackness. Smell. Ugh. Oh, look. Here comes the jolly doctor. And his ethereal, airy wife, Erlene.
Oh, hello there, Erlene.
Lord, I'm so tired from lengths and balls all day. Not to mention looking at them naked people. You know what? I bet I seen every person in this town naked. And when it come to naked, this is a bad-looking town.
What's for supper, sugar?
That's very funny.
And now, a real man. The powerhouse behind the coach.
Aren't you gonna give him a speech?
And now my favorite. A relative. One who has elevated neurosis to an art form.
Oh, hey, y'all, sorry I didn't ask, but I just came by to let y'all know that I will not be going to the state hospital this year. No, see, I decided to have my annual nervous breakdown at home so I could be with my new foreign exchange student, Hunk. Oh, hey, baby, put me down. My leg's starting to fall asleep.
And now we add to this merry mix the great swaggering hero, the lover of boys' games and all things testosterone, the one who calls himself the dad.
That's right, I was playing for the Pittsburgh Steelers. I was the quarterback.
Why do I have such a big stomach? I don't have a stomach like that.
Honey, it's just a play.
It's a play about my stomach.
I was in a play once.
Oh, shut up.
I listen to the wind. It speaks to me. It knows my name. We write letters.
Early? What the hell are you talking about?
You're not a man until your father says so.
And when will that be?
Oh, I don't know. After you win the Heisman Trophy?
I am a man! Come on, Herman, say something! Is it my imagination? Are we being held up for public ridicule?
Oh, he's making us all look like nitwits. But I do like Earlene's outfit.
Son, can I talk to you a minute, please?
How'd you like the play, Coach Newton?
Don't bother asking him, Mr. Ryer. He doesn't like this kind of stuff.
No, actually, I was very impressed. The central theme of alienation that runs through all the characters, mm-hmm. and the unique use of the narrator, you know, breaking the fourth wall and being a symbol of aloneness was wonderful.
Interesting. I had no idea you coaches thought like this.
Well, actually, I have to fight my own sensitivity all the time. A lot of times out in the practice field, I just want to stop and let the boys break into interpretive dance. But then I just beat down my testosterone.
Testosterone. Nice. Well, I must get Taylor's coffin ready for the funeral sequence.
Well, I'd love to leave, but I don't want to miss your funeral.
You're mad.
No. Why should I be mad? Just because you made fools out of your entire family, your friends, in front of everybody out there. That's entertainment?
No, Dad, it's satire. It's symbolism.
That's garbage. Except for Frida. You got her absolutely perfect.
Look, Dad, Mr. Ryer told me to write about what I know.
Well, then write about you being up in your room alone all the time with the door locked all day long watching cable television, ripping Joe Montana's poster off the wall and putting Jim Morrison up there. But don't write about your own family.
Why? Eugene O'Neill wrote about his family. Why can't I?
Because they were dead.
Look, Dad, you don't understand anything about me anymore. You know, I'm really getting...
Don't dad me. Don't dad me. Let me tell you something. Dad. When we get to the funeral party,
Dad.
I want you to be
dad.
Like a corpse.
Dad.
I want you to be dead.
Dad.
What?
I know it seemed like an eternity, but you were on and off so quickly, I'm sure that nobody will even remember.
Mary, I felt like I had egg on my face a long time ago.
Coach!
Huh?
Coach! Coach! A star is born.
Thank you, Nub.
Did you enjoy the play, Nub?
Oh, yes, I did. Although, I thought the dramatic tension sagged a little bit after the fantasy funeral sequence. Of course, my opinion doesn't have the marquee value Neil Hicks does.
What's Neil Heck got to do with it?
He was writing the review for the paper, and when he stopped to go get a donut, I snuck a peek.
Yeah. Was it good?
Yeah.
Well, I don't like jelly donuts myself, but Neil seemed to be enjoying it.
Hey, ho, ho. Look, Newton, we want a word with you.
No, you don't.
She's right. We gotta do something about
this. I'm gonna talk to him.
Talk is cheap. We want revenge.
Now, that plan's supposed to go 3 more weekends, and we got to stop it.
I'm gonna talk to him.
I think we ought to just burn down that theater.
She's starting to scare me more than usual.
Let him do Fiddler on a Roof. That's a happy play, and I'm not in it.
You would it have killed him to give me one line? I mean, one stinking line?
You listen to yourself. Listen to yourself! Remember what it was like to be 17 years old. Do you remember what it was like to be 17? I don't. Hi.
Hi.
Take Amy home?
Yep.
I was listening to one of your tapes.
Yeah, I know.
Great. Well, I like the way they do that song. It's as good as Sinatra. Can I talk to you a minute?
Look, Dad, I really don't want to.
This is important, please.
You want me to rewrite the play, huh?
I didn't say that.
No, but you were thinking it.
Is that what you want to do?
Maybe. I'm not sure. I'm not sure about a lot of things.
Yeah. I'm not gonna give you a lot of bull, but I know exactly how you feel at this time. I realize I don't have any idea where your head is at. I'd like to. I don't know.
I'm fine.
I know. You know, my dad and I, we didn't talk much about. We didn't talk much about anything, but. We sure didn't talk about anything that mattered. I swore when I got a family of my own, I was gonna communicate with them. And especially if I had a son, I was gonna talk to them. And and here I set full of great intentions, but I don't know what to say to you. What to do?
Don't have to say anything.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, we can just hang out, listen to music.
I'd like that.
We can listen to Ella. Huh. Great Satchmo.
Yeah.